Hello. What's my name?
We all know.
We couldn't care less.
Ah, come on. I want to ask you a bunch of questions, but if you don't know who I am, it's not going to make any sense.
Well, your name doesn't have anything to do with who you are.
Okay.
We know you vibrationally.
Yes, I know you do.
Who you are is someone who has as much desire as anyone that we've ever known, who has almost an equal quantity of resistance, which makes things not go as well for you as they should. So you walk around with a sort of chip on your shoulder
yes.
that everyone sees first, and only those who really care about getting to know you ever do.
Yeah, I like that.
We know you intimately and adore you.
Great. But you don't know my name.
We don't care about your name.
Ah.
Jerry knows your name.
Yes, he did. That which
Esther knows your name.
Impressed me very much.
We deliberately do not know your name. We don't even know what color shirt you're wearing. Otherwise, we could have said...
Well, you picked me out, and I have questions. And the questions, I hope, are of a general benefit, but I don't think so. So
and in reality, you don't care.
Well, and, I'm very concerned about me, obviously.
Good.
Because that's the only person I know, and I'm not even sure of that.
Then why tell all those lies?
What lies?
Why tell us that you hope that your questions are of value to others when you really don't
care?
Well,
because we're all basically spirits, and although my particular game is my particular game, everybody has their particular game.
You are an uplifter, and we acknowledge that you do care, and you want what you are about to be of value to others.
Yes, of course.
Yes, you do.
Yeah.
But
that's the only joy there is anywhere, as far as I could see.
Agreed. We agree that it is wonderful to share your joy with others.
3 years ago, you and I had a chat, and you acknowledged that I was a member of the group. And am I still a member, card-carrying member of Abraham?
Yes, but you don't show up at very many meetings.
Okay. I want to start studying.
We're just reflecting back to you the same fun that you are projecting to us.
Good.
In other words, you know there's no card, and you know there's no members in that sense. In other words,
yes.
And you know that you cannot do anything that could cause you to be vibrationally separated from that which is your source. But this alignment is not like a college degree that once you get the paper and put it on your wall that it is yours forevermore. You're aligned in the moment or you're not.
Oh, I thought I was something special, that's why.
You are.
Okay. I think I have done what I was supposed to have done, which is to write a website. Are you aware of that?
We don't care.
Ah, come on.
In other words...
Would you care if I started to study to be a shaman?
We think that that would be a very... effective tool for millions.
For what?
Millions.
Millions. Good. That was one of my questions. That was really the
In other words,
the
there,
question
is,
that I
there
had.
Is no ideology that we would steer you away from because when you desire to be of value and you find a tool that you believe is, then it is. When you believe in the tool of your choice, and you use it as your reason to align, then your alignment is your alignment, and you thrive. That's why there are people who thrive in all religions, in all ideologies.
Okay.
What trips you up is when you choose one and then condemn the others. It is condemnation that separates you from your source. Every religion on the planet, and there are so many more than you are even aware of, every religion on the planet has the potential of absolute thriving. But when you think that you must prove that you have the only one that is right, and you use your condemnation to push against the others, your condemnation separates you from your own connection that you were finding before your condemnation in your own religion. And that's why humans keep trying to kill each other. They keep thinking, if I can just get rid of those that disagree with me, then there will be agreement. And we say, agreement only comes from someone who seeks agreement.
I think you can explain that better. That's really convoluted. It's much simpler if you say, be nice. It really is. If you try to logically look at me, I'm trying to lecture you. Let me ask you a question.
You should show up at more meetings.
In all my reading, there is a consensus that there is a coming of a good, extended good time.
We agree.
Thank you very much.
And we explain to you what it is and
yes.
why it is.
Yes, yes,
but
yes.
we want you to understand
yeah.
that a good time is not had by all. A good time is had only by those who
as
are in vibration.
As long as they have the opportunity, that's all you can do. I mean,
but the opportunity has always been there, and that's the thing.
Fine.
This is the thing that happens with so many. In other words, they want to pronounce something so different about this point in time when the laws of the universe are this steady, consistent thing, you see. You are eternal beings.
The name is Charlie Mazza. What?
We have forgotten already. We will always remember you as the reluctant one.
The next time I see you, please remember my name.
We make no such promise because your name is inconsequential in the eternal scheme of who you are, but your vibration means everything.
Thank you.